online, on your smart speaker, and around the world. This is BC Radio. Debbie McLeod on BC Radio.
Debbie here, Debbie McLeod, bringing you Soulful Journeys, Exploring the Divine. We're here live tonight. Tonight, the focus is all around trust. So we've got lots and lots of different songs around trust. But I just wanted to start off by reading you something that I came across years ago, a poem that was written in a book. And I just wanted to share that with you. So one day, my soul just opened up. And things started happening, things I can't quite explain. I mean, I cried and cried like never before. I cried tears of 10,000 mothers. I couldn't even feel anything because I cried till I was numb. One day my soul just opened up. I felt this overwhelming pride. What I was proud of, only God knows. Like the pride of 100,000 fathers. Basking in the glory of their newborn sons. I was grinning from ear to ear. One day, my soul just opened up. I started laughing, and I laughed what seemed like forever. Wasn't nothing particular funny going on, but I laughed anyhow. I laughed the joy of a million children playing in the mud. I laughed till my sides ached. Oh God, it felt so good. One day my soul just opened up. There were revelations, annihilations and resolutions, feelings of doubt and betrayal, vengeance and forgiveness, memories of things I've seen and done before, of places I've been, although I don't know when. There were lives I'd lived, people I'd loved, battles I'd fought, victories I'd won, and wars I'd lost. One day my soul just opened up. And outpoured all the things I'd been hiding and denying and living through that had just happened moments before. One day my soul just opened up and I decided I was good and ready. I was good and ready to surrender my life to God, to the universe, to angels, however we see that higher power. So with my soul wide open, I sat down and I wrote her a note. And told her so. So that's a beautiful reminder there about how when we come from that space within us where we are surrendering and becoming more of ourselves and just letting the things that no longer serve us just drop from our memories, when we shut those doors and we decide that there's change that is needed, then it's a wonderful, wonderful thing. So I just want to say about the definition of soulful. So soulful for me is an objective describing the quality of being authentic, having genuine depth and expressing yourself from the soul. A soulful person lives authentically, purposely, and with depth. And spirituality involves that recognition of being or a sense or a belief that there's something greater than yourself, something more to being human than sensory experience, and that the great whole of who we are is cosmic or divine in nature. Soulful Journeys is about what makes your soul come alive, what connects you to a deeper meaning inside when you're connecting with others. And living soulfully means going beyond looking and feeling good. It's more about being mindful of your thoughts or transcending that beautiful ego of ours. It's about being able to tune in to your own inner compass and determine what feels right for you. So this week, we're going to look at that beautiful word, trust. Trust of ourselves and trust of others and trust life. But before we get started, I've just noticed that my colleague, Di with a Y, has just come into the studio because she's preparing for her show later on tonight from 8 till 10. So Di, do you know what have we got coming up?
Oh, very interesting, actually. This the show will be 80s alternative tracks like Joy Division, Bauhaus, Simple Minds. And my show, I think we've actually called it Wednesday Nights at Wigan Pier, Sounds of Yesteryear. So we're in for a treat. So it's lots of memories from the 80s, a few shout-outs to a few people who have put requests in. So if you like Joy Division, Fad Gadget, Thomas Dolby, Brian Eno, lots of other alternative tracks. I'll be playing all those. So, yeah, something interesting. I love it as well, dipping back in time for me. So, yeah, I'll see you all in a little while.
Yeah, in a couple of hours. That'll be great. I know she's going to be working hard now to get that all ready for you. So that's Die with a Y from 8 till 10. So back to my show tonight, and again, as I was saying, it's around trust. So here, the first song that we've got is by Jay Escobar, and it's Trust the Process.
Touch miracles hidden inside of us. Ordinary days don't seem to mean a thing at the time. We're blind to the divine. We're born to fall in love. We're made to rise above. We were told to sacrifice.
Beautiful song there, Trust the Process by Jay Escobar. And the thing about that is in the lyrics, he talks about, I've got to trust the things we can't touch. Miracles are hidden inside of us. Beautiful, beautiful song. So it really is about trusting that unseen, unknown, knowing that everything is working for our highest good, regardless of what situations that we're facing. We have to let go. There is that saying, let go and let God, but we have to surrender to things, to knowing that we just don't actually know the answers to everything, and we don't know how things are going to turn out. And the miracles are hidden inside of us, and we just need to bring those miracles out, and to by trusting the process, we will do that. We will do it. So we're going to the next song is Trust by Etta James. And the lyrics are about a woman asking her partner to trust her and have faith in their relationship. She promises that if he trusts her, their love will then see them through the difficult times. She encourages him to come to her when things go wrong and promises to be strong for him. She asks him to stand beside her and face the future together with a smile, and assures him that if he only trusts in her, they can get through anything. So my question there would be, how are you trusting others without giving all of yourself away to someone else? So where is that boundary? Where is that little bit of inside of us that sometimes holds us back from completely trusting other people, from things that have happened? So it's always good to be aware of, where are we in that trust, in that journey of trust, where are we? So enjoy Trust by Etta James. Maybe not quite right now. There we go. So, Trust Yourself by Etta James.
trust yourself.
Beautiful, the wonderful wisdom and words from Etta James there in Trust Yourself. And I always like to play music right to the end because I sometimes find the way in which a song finishes, it kind of like touches my soul because it just, I don't know, it's like this definitive moment that the song's coming to an end, and it's like it just pulls it all together for me, whether it's the acoustics, whether it's just the musical instruments, whatever it is, there's just this beautiful ending to a song. So that was Trust Yourself with Etta James from the album Let's Roll. So we're moving on now in our choice of songs, and we're moving on to Trust Yourself by Bob Dylan. So the central theme of Trust Yourself revolves around the idea of self-belief and the importance of staying true to one's inner voice. So that inner voice is crucial when we're making decisions for ourselves, when we know who to trust and when we don't know who to trust. And sometimes we can take that discussion, if you like, into our heads and self-sabotage ourselves and talk ourselves, as I say, out of things, when actually we've got this little inner voice that's saying, no, 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 don't trust this person, don't do that. And we go, oh, you know, I'll just give this person another, yeah, I'll just let them and it'll be okay. We'll see. They won't make the same mistake again. And 9 times out of 10, we make the same mistake again for trusting in other people, because we're all human. But actually, we need to listen to that beautiful little inner voice. Actually, we need to be still and quiet to hear it, because it's knocking all the time to say, think about this, what about this? But we're just so busy as we're rushing around. So Bob Dylan in Trust Yourself. So do you listen to your inner voice, or do you self-sabotage yourself? So enjoy Trust Yourself, Bob Dylan.
Trust yourself. Trust yourself to do the things that only you know best. Trust yourself. Trust yourself to do what's right and not be second guessed. Don't trust me to show you beauty when beauty may only turn to rust. If you need somebody you can trust, trust yourself. Trust yourself. Trust yourself to know the way. There is no if and when. Don't trust me to show you the truth when the truth may only be ashes and dust. If you want somebody you can trust, trust yourself. When you're on your own, you always were in a land of wolves and thieves. Don't put your
lovely there. Bit of Bob Dylan for you. And that's from his album Empire Burlesque, Trust Yourself. So again, that question was, do you listen to your inner voice or do you self-sabotage yourself and talk yourself out of things? It's very easy to do that, isn't it? We just have to be aware that we're actually doing that to ourselves and to quieten that mind, which sometimes is easier said than done. But we get there. So the next song up is by Billy Joel, and it's A Matter of Trust. And in this song, Joel sings about what it takes to make a relationship last. Once those waves of passion subside, it becomes a partnership where the couple have to trust each other and be there in their times of need. So that's taking that relationship to that deeper, deeper level. So please enjoy Billy Joel, A Matter of Trust.
One, two, one, two, three, four.